हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ लैंग्वेज, दैट इज़ अ पुश डाउन ऑटोमेटा और वी कैन से PDA. सो द पुश डाउन ऑटोमेटा इज़ अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा. ओके, इट इज़ जस्ट लाइक अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा विद सम एक्स्ट्रा मेमोरी, विच इज़ अ वेरी, यू कैन से इट्स अ वेरी एडवांटेजियस फैक्ट विद द PDA, दैट इट हैज़ सम एक्स्ट्रा मेमोरी कॉल्ड स्टैक, which play a very important role in the pushdown automata. So which helps the pushdown automata to recognize the context-free language. As we already discussed that if we have a context-free language and for machines, the machine that generate the context-free language, that machine is called pushdown automata. So here we are going to discuss that machine, that is PDA. So in the PDA, we use an extra memory that is called stack, which helps the PDA to recognize the context-free language. As we know that this stack has two operation, or we can say in stack we can perform two operation. One is pop and another one is push. Pop means whenever a new element is added, we always add at the top of the stack, okay? And in push, the top element of the stack is read and then we remove, or we can say, or we can push it. So in the PDA, we use an extra memory called stack, and with the help of a stack, we can pop the symbol from into the stack and push the symbol from the stack. Okay, then this PDA are used in theories about what can be computed by machines. Okay. And they are more capable than finite state machine, but less capable than Turing machine. The Turing machine concept we will discuss in my future video. But the PDA are more capable of doing some computation than the finite state machine, but they are less capable than Turing machine. So this is the basic concept about PDA. Now, how PDA work, or what are the, you can say, what are the symbols we are using while performing some operation on the PDA. So the PDA can be defined by some symbol Q, sigma, Q naught, F, this is transition function del, Z, and this is stop. So in pushdown automata, this Q is set of states, okay, this sigma is input symbol, this Q naught is initial state, this F is set of final state, okay, this del is the transition function, this Z is, this is the two new symbols that we are added in the PDA, that is Z and tau. So this Z is initial pushdown symbol, that always contain, or initially the stack contain this Z value, which is always at the bottom of the stack. Okay, and this tau is set of pushdown symbol. It is a set of pushdown symbol that can be pushed or popped from the stack. Okay, so this is the whole symbols which are defined in the PDA. Now this transition function del can be defined into two ways. If the transition function, or if the PDA is a deterministic, then the transition function is defined in another way. And if the PDA is a non-deterministic PDA, then the transition defined by another way. So if this transition function, or you can say the pushdown automata, is deterministic, then this transition function can be defined as Q into this input symbol, okay, and with some epsilon, or it always combined with tau, and it gives Q tau to the power star. And if this is a non-deterministic, okay, if the transition function is non-deterministic, then it can be defined as Q sigma union with epsilon, and with tau, then it gives 2 to the power Q into tau to the power star. So this is how we can define the transition function in case of deterministic and non-deterministic symbol. So PDA will read the input symbol and stack symbol from the top of the stack and move to a new state and change the symbol of the stack. So next we explain how this PDA will be work. Then first we discuss what are the components of PDA. Okay. So for working with PDA, there are some components we are using in PDA. So the first component is input tape. Okay, so the first component of PDA is input tape, and it is divided into many cells or symbols. The input is head, is read only and may only move from left to right. Okay, so this is the functionality of the input tape. Then the next component is, this is input from the input, from the input tape we read some input and give to the next component, that is finite control. Now the functionality of this finite control is that it has same pointer which points the current symbol which is to be read and which is to be read. Okay, then from this finite control, the next component is stack, from which we can push or pop the symbol. Okay, so we can define the stack as a structure in which we can push or remove the item from one end only, and it has an infinite size and it is always used to store the item temporarily. So from this we can push the item or pop the item, and after this whether we can accept or reject the string. So this is the PDA component. So there are three components in PDA. One is input tape, second is finite control, and third one is stack. In input tape, the input head is read only and may only move from left to right. This finite control has the same pointer which points the current symbol which is to be read, and this stack is used for pushing or popping the item from one end only. Okay, so this is the PDA component. Now the one more important point is the instantaneous description. So in PDA we use one term called ID or instantaneous description, which can be defined as an informal notation of how a PDA computes an input string, okay, and then make a decision that the string is either accepted or not. So this instantaneous description can be defined by using a tuple, or you can say triplet, by using a triplet called Q, W and A, where this Q is current state, okay, this W is remaining input which is to be read, and this A is stack content which is always the top at the left. Okay, so this instantaneous description we are going to use in the in the example. So this ID can be defined by a triplet called QWA, which this Q defines the current state, W defines the remaining input, and A defines the stack content. So this is the basic concept of about PDA, that what is a PDA is. In the PDA we use a very special memory called stack, which is can be used for pushing or popping the symbol. Okay, then there are some components we are using in PDA, that is input tape, finite control and stack. Okay, and then in the PDA we are using a term called ID, that is called instantaneous description. Now we are going to discuss the one important example on the topic of PDA. Okay, so the example is that we have to define a push down automata for a language, that is a to the power n, b to the power n, where n is greater than 0. So we have to construct a pushdown automata for this particular language. So a to the power n or b to the power n means the language can be as a b b or a b b b and so on. So we have to construct the pushdown automata for this particular language. Now for designing or for constructing a pushdown automata, we have some certain steps. Okay, as we know that in the pushdown automata we use some symbol. That symbol is q sigma q naught f transition function zn this tau. This z is the initial pushdown symbol, okay, which is always contained in the bottom of the stack, and this tau contain the set of pushdown symbol. Okay, so before start this problem, we know that we have a stack in which z is always contained at the bottom of this stack. Now roughly if we discuss about this pushdown automata, we can say that whenever first a symbol encounter, we push it into the stack, okay, and whenever this b symbol encounter, we always pop this a for every b. So we compare this b, and this b will be compared with this a, and then after we read all the symbols, the last is epsilon, which always denotes that the input symbol will be read, and we always reach to the last, or we always reach to the last symbol. So for every a, if we encounter the first a, we push it into the stack, then we move ahead, then we again encounter with the a, again we push it into the stack. When we encounter this b, so we pop this a, this b is compared with a, and this b is compared with this a, and then when we encounter this b, then we pop this a. So there are some steps which can be performed like this. So first we design our state transition diagram for this pushdown automata for the language a to the power n or b to the power n. Initially, the initial state can be defined as q naught, which is our initial state. As we know that whenever we encounter the first a, okay, encounter with the first a, that see here, the in pointer is at, the input symbol is a, and the top of the stack is z. So we push it into the stack. So how we denote this? See, if we a b b and epsilon, so if we encounter with the first a, or the input symbol is a, so initially the stack contains z only. So see here, if the input symbol is a and the top of the stack is z, so we push this a into the stack, so we denote it like this. Once again, the input symbol is a, so a comma, the top of the stack is z, so a comma z, so we push this a into the stack, so we represent it as a z. Then now again, then this second a encounter, okay, so we this is a transition for this. Again, for this again transition, we can be denoted as, if the input symbol is a, the top of the stack is again a, so we move this a into the stack, so we denote like this. So this a is input symbol, this a is top of the stack, so we move this second a into the stack, so we denote like aa. Now we encounter with b, the top of the stack is a, so for every b we have to pop one a, so we pop this a for this b, so we denote by like this. If the input symbol is b, top of the stack is a, so we pop this a for this b, so we denote like by epsilon move, okay, and we reach to our next state, that is q1. Okay, now again, for this b, the input symbol is b, we are at the Q1 state, and if the input symbol is B and the top of the stack is A, so again we push, pop this A for this B, so we denote like this. So the input symbol is A, the top of the stack is A, sorry, the input symbol is B, the top of the stack is A, so we pop this A for this B, so we denote it by B, A / epsilon. Now, the last is, the input symbol is epsilon, the top of the stack is Z, so we denote like, the input symbol is epsilon, the top of the stack is Z, so this denotes that we read all the string, or we reach to the end state, so it denotes, means the stack contain only Z only, and we can say that we reach to the final state, that is QF. So this is the state transition diagram for this particular language, this is the push down automata for this particular language. Okay, now if we have to construct the transition function for this push down automata for this particular language, then the transition function will be look like, see, we have take the string AABB. So for this particular input string, what is the transition function with the help of this state transition diagram? See here, if the input symbol is A, initially we are at Q0 state, okay? The input symbol is A. Initially the stack contains Z. So initially we are at the Q0 state, the input symbol is A, the top of the stack is Z, so we push this A into the stack. So this will give, we remain in the same state and the stack contain AZ. Okay, then next we encounter the second A. So again we are at the same state, that is Q0. We have an input symbol A and the top of the stack is A. So again we are in the same state. So this is Q0 A. Okay, then the input symbol is B. So right now we are on the same state Q0. The input symbol is B, the top of the stack is A, so for this, see here, from Q0, the input symbol is B, the top of the stack is A, so we pop this A for this B and we have epsilon, so and we will reach to the next state, that is Q1, so Q1, epsilon, so we pop this A for this B. Now for the next B, we are on the Q1 state, okay? We are on the Q1 state, the input symbol is B, okay, the top of the stack is A, again we pop this A for this B and we will remain in the same state Q1, so Q1, epsilon, so we keep on popping it. Now the last is epsilon, so we are on the Q1 state, the input symbol is epsilon, the top of the stack is Z, so it will give to, or we reach to the final state QF with the stack contain Z. So this is the transition function for this particular language, A to the power N, B to the power N, or we can say this is a deterministic push down automata, because for every state or for every input symbol we have only one move, or we can reach to a single state for every input symbol. So this is called, or you can say this is an example of deterministic push down automata. Okay, so we explain this example, or you can show this example in the examination like this. Suppose we have a same example, okay? So for the input string AABB, so draw table like this. Row, state, input, transition, stack value, and state after move. So you can design this table in the examination purpose. So the first is that initially we are on the Q0 state, the input is AABB, there is no transition function, initially the stack contains the Z value, और सो वी आर ऑन द क्यू नॉट स्टेट. ओके सो फर्स्ट वी रीड दिस इनपुट सिंबल ए. सो इनिशियली वी आर ऑन द क्यू नॉट स्टेट एंड वी रीड दिस ए. सो वी टेक इट लाइक दिस ए बी बी. सो द ट्रांजिशन फंक्शन सी हियर क्यू नॉट ए जेड. सो वी रीच टू द क्यू नॉट ए जेड. सो यू कैन शो लाइक वी आर ऑन द क्यू नॉट स्टेट. इनपुट सिंबल इज ए. टॉप ऑफ द स्टैक इज जेड. सो इट पुश ए इन टू द स्टैक एंड इट वी रिमेन इन द स्टेम स्टेट दैट इज क्यू नॉट. सो क्यू नॉट ए जेड एंड द स्टैक कंटेन ए जेड एंड वी आर ऑन द सेम स्टेट क्यू नॉट. नाउ नेक्स्ट वी आर ऑन द सेम स्टेट क्यू नॉट. नाउ वी रीड दिस ए सिंबल. सो अगेन वी रीड दिस ए सिंबल. सो वी डिनोट द ट्रांजिशन फंक्शन लाइक दिस ए. इनपुट सिंबल इज ए. टॉप ऑफ द स्टैक इज ए. सो वी रीच ऑन द सेम स्टेट क्यू नॉट एंड द स्टैक कंटेन ए ए. दिस एंड द स्टैक कंटेन ए ए जेड एंड वी आर ऑन द सेम स्टेट दैट इज क्यू नॉट. नाउ द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज वी आर ऑन द क्यू नॉट स्टेट. वी रीड दिस फर्स्ट बी. सो एज वी रीड बी सो द ट्रांजिशन इज वी आर ऑन द क्यू नॉट स्टेट. द इनपुट सिंबल इज बी. द टॉप ऑफ द स्टैक इज ए. सो वी पॉप दिस ए फॉर दिस बी एंड वी रीच टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेट दैट इज क्यू वन एंड क्यू वन एंड द वी हैव एन एप्सिलॉन मूव. द स्टैक कंटेन ओनली ए जेड एंड वी रीच टू द क्यू वन स्टेट. नाउ द फिफ्थ वन. ओके सो वी रीच वी आर ऑन द क्यू वन स्टेट ए ए बी बी. सो अगेन वी रीड दिस बी. सो वी आर ऑन द क्यू वन स्टेट. द इनपुट सिंबल इज बी एंड द टॉप ऑफ द स्टैक इज ए. सो वी रीच ऑन द सेम स्टेट विद एप्सिलॉन मूव. द स्टैक कंटेन ओनली जेड हियर एंड वी रीच टू द क्यू वन स्टेट. नाउ आफ्टर क्यू वन स्टेट ए ए बी बी और एप्सिलॉन. सो दिस नाउ वी रीड एप्सिलॉन मूव. सो वी आर ऑन द क्यू वन स्टेट. इनपुट सिंबल इज एप्सिलॉन. टॉप ऑफ द स्टैक इज जेड. सो वी रीच टू द QF state that is the final state or you can say Q2 state with the Z and the stack contains Z and we reach to the QF state which is a final state. So this is how you can also design the pushdown automata, deterministic pushdown automata in some this table also in or we can say design the transition function or you can define the example solution with the help of the state transition diagram. Now there are some observation or you can say the most important thing that in some books the last step which is shown as when we have a Q1 state symbol symbol is Q epsilon. The top of the stack is Z. So we reach to the QF final state and Z. In some books this step can be shown as Q1 input symbol is epsilon. Stack contains Z and we reach to the Q1 and epsilon. So if we take this step, this means that the string is accepted by a final state. So this means string is accepted by final state. Okay, and if you are taking like this, so this means that string is accepted by empty stack. So both are correct. You can use any of them. Okay, so if you are using Z which is the top of the stack, so this means that string is accepted by the final state. And if you are using like Q1 comma epsilon, okay, so this means the string is accepted by the empty stack. So there are some observation that this problem is called deterministic pushdown automata in nature because there is only one move for a state on every input symbol and the stack symbol. Okay, because in the non-deterministic pushdown automata we have more than one move for a state on any input symbol and stack symbol. Okay, and it is not always possible to convert a non-deterministic pushdown automata to deterministic pushdown automata. Or the pushdown automata can either be implemented, as we know that, by using an acceptant by the empty state or by the final state. So this is how we can solve a deterministic pushdown automata. I hope you have no doubt or you understood this very clearly. And still, if you have any doubt, then you can ask in our comment section. okay, and keep watching my video, and in my next video I'm going to explain the non-deterministic finite automata example. So thank you so much.